All right. Hi, everyone. I'm back, but I brought a friend this time, and we're going to talk about financials.
I am a product marketing manager on the marketplace team, and I'm excited to partner with Jen to talk about financials.
We have a packed agenda today. We know financials are an area where folks tend to have very specific individualized questions, but also we know that it's super important that if you feel confident that you're getting paid appropriately and you understand sort of how all the debits and credits come together. So Alex and I are going to hopefully give you a refresher of all the different things you can do in the portal and the information you can get about your financials. And as always, we'll have time at the end for questions. So we all know setting up your financial information on the portal is really important so that you can get your payouts to run smoothly. So the goal of today is to make sure that you know how to make sure that your financial information was set up properly, and that you understand where you can get access to this information. All right, payouts. What are payouts? So we think of payouts as the log in which you can see how much you're getting paid out by DoorDash. And most merchants are on a weekly payout schedule, although eligible merchants can also opt in for daily payouts as well. So you have sort of two different options. But either way, if you go to the financials tab in the merchant portal, you can select payouts. And here you can see the history of all of the payouts you've received from DoorDash. So you can look at it over the past 7 or 30 days. You can also put in a custom time frame to see your payouts. And while you can see it in the portal, here you could click on that payout ID and see every transaction that's associated with the payout. You can also click the Create Report button, which will launch our report builder tool where you can also download your payout information. A couple things I'll call out here. Right now on the screenshot, you can see that this is showing a paid payout. We will also show you if you have a pending or canceled payout as well. So you have a little bit of information similar to maybe what you might see on like a credit card website where you can see sort of what's happening relatively real time. And we also have some of the financial columns that we have in our report listed here, although this doesn't show all of the details. So if you wanted to better understand fees, what fees make up that fee total, if you download the report, you can see more details. But at a high level, this will sort of show you your sales subtotal, your taxes, your commissions, fees, staff tips, et cetera. So you can, again, just sort of get a high level snapshot. And as a reminder, you get paid out the Thursday after the week that you had those transactions. So in this example, the transactions occurred from July 4th through the 10th, and this merchant was paid out for those transactions on July 14th, so a few days later. So it'll always be a few days after you completed those transactions. All right, Report Builder. So as I mentioned in the last masterclass, if you were here, our report builder is the tool that you use to get your financial information and to download it so you can review it, upload it to your accounting software if you use something to manage your money in some other fashion or so that you can send it to your accountant, etc. So in Report Builder, you can select financials. It's one of our report types. And from there, we have three different types of reports. Transactions, which is the list of literally every transaction you've had during that time period. Error charges and adjustments. So that's just a list of any of your transactions where there was some sort of an error charge or an adjustment made. So that could be the customer reported that their soda was missing, and so you were charged for that, or they were dissatisfied with their order, et cetera. So you can just see your error charges during that period of time. And then payouts, which I just explained in a lot of detail, so I won't belabor the point, but you can see the list of all your payouts with the payouts report. So you can select all three or just one of these, and then you can also select the time frame. So again, we have data that goes back 2 years, so you could pull all of your payouts for the past 2 years if you want to, and then you would hit create report, and within a matter of seconds, the report will be available for you to download.
And we also have something called monthly statements, which is an aggregated view of your payouts for the month. You'll be able to see your sales, any error charges, adjustments, your transactions, and it will be broken out by your payout. So if you receive 4 payouts in October, you'll see all 4 of those in the October statement. You can download this as a PDF, which is very useful. And in the appendix, there's a glossary of our financial terms, which very helpful when there's so many line items here. We define all of them in the back.
And I just want to call out that this is like a really visually easy to digest version of some of the reporting I was just talking about. So these all should show you the exact same amounts of subtotals, net totals, et cetera. It's just different ways, depending on how you want to consume your financial information. It's just different ways that you can download it and digest it. So the PDF, I think we found, is really great if you're a smaller business. But again, it doesn't prevent you from downloading the same information from the sections I just talked about.
And if you want to find this, you'll log into your merchant portal and you'll navigate to the financials tab. In the subsection, you'll see something called statements, and you'll be able to select the month that you want to download and hit download, and you'll have that PDF forever and ever. So next, I'm going to talk to you about DoorDash Capital. So this is really exciting. This is a new partnership we have with Paraffin, and it's a cash advance. So we're offering our merchants the ability to have easy access to financing. This cash advance, you don't need to apply. You can actually see if you're eligible in the merchant portal. So you'll log into the merchant portal and click on the financials tab, and you'll see if you have an offer. The offer is based on your previous sales performance on DoorDash. So if you don't see one now, it doesn't mean you won't ever see one, just based on your historical transaction history with DoorDash. Something that is unique about DoorDash Capital is that there is no interest. This is a cash advance, and you pay a one-time fee. And then you choose your repayment schedule, as well as how you want to pay it back, what repayment period, so that percentage, and it is taken out of your weekly sales from DoorDash. So again, just log into the merchant portal and navigate to the financials tab. You can also look in the solutions center and see if the pile is there, then you're eligible, and you'll see the fee up front, and you'll know how much you can withdraw for your cash advance. Once you accept the terms, you can spend the money however you want to. Right now, we're seeing most merchants spend the money on new equipment and staffing.
And so this is also just a great option if, let's say, you know you want to offer, I'm going to make something up, desserts. And in order to do that, you need some sort of a special oven to bake cookies. And you know that you may not have the cash available to you to do that, but you know that if you had the equipment, you could put it on your menu and it'd be really successful. We view this as a great way to help you have that opportunity to grow your business. And it's integrated in the portal so that you can see how much you're getting. And then in those financial sections of the portal, you can see it reflected, right? It'll be taken out of your payout. So again, there's full transparency, and we kind of connect the dots for you in our tools. So in addition to all the different ways that Alex and I just talked about that you can get access to information about your store's financial information, you can also opt in for performance information to be sent to you on a regular basis. So it's essentially a snapshot of your weekly or daily sales and some other high-level financial details. So at any time, you can go into the merchant portal to opt in to receive these reports. So you go to your account setting tab. In there, there's an email preferences section where you can then toggle on the button so that you can be subscribed to receive either daily reports, weekly reports, or if you really want, you can get both daily and weekly. And they'll just automatically be sent to you every single day or every single week, again, with just a high-level summary and then an easy link to click into the financial section of the portal so you can learn more details. We have found that for a lot of our business owners, this is a really easy way to make sure you kind of have that quick pulse on how your business is performing. Without feeling like you have to remember to log into the portal and navigate to the tab, right? It just sort of summarizes everything for you. And if at some point you decide that you no longer want to receive the emails, you want to change the cadence, at any time you can go back to the account settings tab and go back to this email preferences section and change your preferences. So to learn more about everything Alex and I talked about, you can go to the Learning Center.
So navigate to get.doordash.com. And you'll see in the resources section, there's the blog, the Learning Center. The Learning Center has everything from getting set up to how to manage your financials and how to add photos, how to add descriptions. It's a how-to for anything you might want to do on DoorDash.
And there are several articles in the Learning Center that can be helpful and have information about what Alex and I talked about today. So I would definitely recommend going there and checking out the various options. And for your handy reference, we have the QR code here if you want to scan it now so that you can quickly be navigated to the How to Add Financial Information to Your Merchant Portal article. But again, there are multiple sections in the Learning Center that touch on the topics we discussed today. So if you're interested in any of them, I would highly recommend going there to learn more.